Well, first I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. This is a huge group. Thank you for taking time out to come meet with me. As Dr. Smith told you, I am Ms. MacDonald. I work with American University of Antigua. I'm their Associate Director of Admissions. So I'm just going to share some information with you tonight about our university. Just another option for you guys to keep in mind. You can come in. Don't be shy. Hi. You can sit right here. I'll move this for you. You can fill it out for me. I'm Ms. MacDonald. Nice to meet you. So there's my contact information. You don't have to take it down now unless you want to, but Dr. Smith can always give you my information so that you can contact me directly if you have any questions. So today what I'm going to talk to you about is medical school and our affiliated institutions, which are AI-CASA and KMCIC, what it's like to live in Antigua or in India, the admissions requirements, and tuition costs, which I know all of you want to know about tuition, right? So the impending physician shortage. I'm sure all of you know that there is an impending physician shortage, and that's due to accelerating MD retirements, inadequate supply of minority MDs, growing and aging population, new illnesses, healthcare legislation, and insufficient number of new MDs. Now this is the applicant pool when it comes to applying to med school. So you've got applicants to medical schools, 43,919 U.S. applicants. Out of those, 24,689 wind up in the unaccepted pool. Then you have 16,788 that either delay, change career paths, or enroll in other medical related programs. And out of the ones that's left, you have the matriculation into medical schools of 19,230 students, into osteopathic is around 5,000, and the U.S. Model of Caribbean Medical Schools, 3,500, totaling 8,500. So what's AUA's mission? Our mission is to provide a learner-centric medical education that meets the highest standards of academic excellence. So our job is to make sure that you're successful as physicians. We want to make sure that you get the best education possible. We want to provide you with educational resources that are going to empower you as far as becoming a compassionate physician, a lifelong learner, because being a physician is going to require you to be a lifelong learner. Things are going to constantly change, and you're going to need to be on top of all of the new changes, all of the new technology, and also be leaders in addressing the global shortage of healthcare providers. So one of our programs is AI-CASA. That's our pre-med program. So that may not apply to many of you here because you'll complete your pre-med requirements here at Clemson and then you'll go on to medical schools. But for an individual who is interested in taking the pre-med requirements at AI-CASA, this would be the program that they would attend. So it's a two-year Associate in Science program. You'll earn a BS, HHS, and an MD in 6 years. It's accredited by ACICS, and we have 3 start dates, which are January, May, and September. We offer the same program at Kasturba Medical College, which is in India. And it's a 2x2 global MD program. It affords both institutions access to shared faculty, joint library archives, and educational resources, and they have start dates of February and August. Most of you are probably interested in the College of Medicine, and that's what we're talking about here. You do basic sciences 2 semesters per year, so you're on the island for 2 years. It's a clinically correlated curriculum. We have clinical rotations in the U.S., in Canada, and in India, and we offer 2 start dates, which are February and August. We are approved by the New York State Education Department. We are recognized by the Medical Board of California. We have CAM approval, which is accreditation by the Caribbean Accreditation Authority for Medicine. And we're approved by the American Association of Physicians of Indian Origin. So outstanding leadership. This gentleman is one of our leaders at AUA. He is a University of Rochester School medical graduate. He's the editor-in-chief of the Journal of American College of Surgeons, and he has written 2 different textbooks to his credit, Dr. Schwartz. And then some of our other outstanding faculty that have held prestigious positions at prestigious institutions, as well as representing over 15 countries. So we have a very diverse faculty as well as a very diverse student body. Together they've published over 1,000 papers. So our campus, and Dr. Smith can attest to this. It's the most modern medical school in the Caribbean. It's a multi-million dollar technologically advanced 17-acre campus. I just came back in August. It was absolutely beautiful. I could not believe what I saw. I was floored. You have 24 access to a high-tech library. It's air conditioned. We have Wi-Fi everywhere, Wi-Fi enabled classrooms, and we even have some intramural sports if you're interested in participating in that. The basic science curriculum is made up of 4 semesters in Antigua, as I told you previously, which follow the new paradigm in medical education, which is problem-based learning. You're going to focus on ABMS competencies, which are aligned with the U.S. recommendations. We have modern classrooms and laboratories, clinically correlated curriculum, hospital experience in your first semester. You'll go to Mount St. John's, and you'll be able to get hands-on experience with patients from day one. And you've got accessibility to our faculty and our teaching assistants. Within the basic science curriculum, we also have an educational enhancement center, Center for Simulated Learning, which is my favorite. I told them to just leave me in there for like an hour so I could play with the Sim Man 3G or the Sim Baby or the birthing center. It's amazing. Blackboard Learn, Echo 360, Lecture Capture, Enhancement and Remediation, and Preparation, of course, for your USMLE Step 1 clinical and your clinical. We also have another unique piece, which is the MBA, MPH, and MHA opportunities that are offered through the state and Walden. So these affiliation agreements allow our students to actually participate in these classes and earn these degrees while they're going to school and earning their MD degree. So Superior USMLE Board Exam Preparation, shelf exams. It's basically the subject matter exams written by the NBME, and it's made up of retired Step 1 questions. So from day one when you walk in the classroom, your exams are going to be those exams. They're going to start prepping you from day one to be able to sit for this exam. We're the first international school to administer the web-based NBME, say that 3 times fast, exam. 90% of all the basic science courses have shelf exams, and we mimic the exam environment so that you are actually being acclimated from day one. You'll sit for the comprehensive self-exam 1 before taking your Step 1 exam. So now the Educational Enhancement Department, our EED department. Dr. Haley is professor and chair of EED, and this department offers you the academic support and professional development that you'll need on the road to becoming a physician. So we offer one-on-one academic advising. We offer the medical scholars, discussion leaders, and teaching assistants. They're there to help you. Office of Disabilities, if you have some sort of disability going on and you need assistance, they can help you. Professional development, such as student leadership, strategy courses, and doctor's bags, all there to help you to build up your resume and become better physicians. The Center for Simulated Learning, my favorite place on the whole campus. It's equipped with the latest training simulators, which is the Simman 3G, the Sim Baby, Harvey, and the Birthing Simulator. It's interactive software and clinical scenarios. The clinical skills are assessed individually or in groups, and you apply the basic science knowledge in clinical situations. So basically, you'll go in there, they'll code Harvey for whatever it is that they want you to figure out, whatever illness they want you to be able to figure out what's going on with Harvey, and you'll go through the motions, and he talks to you, which was so cool. You guys probably think I'm crazy, but it was so cool. And this is actually the same technology that the military uses to train their medics. So that's very interesting, and it's very helpful. Mount St. John's is the medical center that is located there in Antigua. It's actually brand new. It opened in 2009. There's 185 beds, 5 operating theaters, electronic record system, 16-slice CT scanner, and a full endoscopy suite. Mount St. John's is the most modern medical facility in the Leeward Islands, which is where Antigua is located, and you're exposed to those clinical environments within the hospital. Clinical rotations in the U.S. Lots of students think that if they go to an offshore medical school, that they will not be able to get clinical rotations in the U.S. That is not true. You'll get clinical rotations in the U.S. It's going to be your final 2 years, 84 weeks. It'll be in affiliated U.S. teaching hospitals, could be anywhere across the country. You'll do your core clerkships in internal medicine, surgery, pediatrics, obstetrics and gynecology, psychiatry, and family practice. You can also elect to do elective clerkships as well in areas of specialty that you might be interested in. Some people want to do plastics, some people want to do anesthesiology, some people want to do neurology. You can do that as well. And this is the breakdown of the U.S. residencies. As you can see, the U.S. med school seniors, 17,662. Foreign medical school grads, 2,960. And then other is 4,904. And breakdown, color-coded breakdown of each one. So you see U.S. med school match rate is 95%, and the foreign med school match rate, 49% for U.S. citizens. So residency success. So our graduates have been put in very prestigious positions through the National Residency Match Program, as you can see. Places like Brown University, Drexel University, Boston University, those are huge. So there's great opportunities out there for our students. 2012 residency appointments. This breaks it down for you by specialty. And as you can see, the largest portion of the graph is the 31% and 35%, which is family medicine and internal medicine. That's where the biggest shortages are. So our goal at AUA is to train physicians who can fill those shortages. So here's a graduation timeline, basically breaking it down for you, showing you if you started school in 2013, August, what your timeline would be from basic sciences through graduation and starting your residency. So as you can see, August of 2013, basic science 1, February, basic science 2, August of 2014, basic science 3, February of 2014, basic science 4, June of 2015, the comp exam, USMLE step 1, and you would start your first core rotation. September 2016, you'd be in taking your step 2, and you'd move on to your elective rotations in October of 2016. May of 2017, your degree would be awarded. In June, you would graduate, and in July, you would start your residencies. So what's Antigua like? Antigua is very, very modern. It's the ideal location for study of medicine if you can stay focused with 365 beaches, one for every day. I don't know, me personally, probably couldn't stay focused. I'd probably be jumping all over the place, but that's me. Modern comfort and familiar lifestyle is really, I couldn't believe when I got there, like our housing and just grocery stores. Grocery stores are a little bit more expensive, but they have everything that you have here. It's imported, so of course it will be a little bit more expensive, but you do have the option if you wish. I know that some students have done it. They just get a barrel and they fill it up with everything that they want or could need for the entire time that they're going to be there for that first semester, and they ship it out there. And actually, you would think it might be more expensive, but it's really not. It costs you about $100 to ship the barrel, put everything in it. Then you'll pick it up from customs, they'll go through it, and it's usually about $100, $150 once they assess what's actually in the barrel. So over time, it's a lot less expensive than buying groceries there. But while I was there, I bought groceries. I found everything that I wanted, everything that I liked. I just had to get used to EC versus the US dollar. Had to do the conversion. English is the primary language. We do have direct flights from many U.S. cities. I was telling some students that were here early. We have flights, direct flights from Atlanta, direct flights from Miami, direct flights from Charlotte, and there may be some other direct flights. I know there's direct flights from New York. So that is possible. We do have the large supermarkets that I said are stocked with familiar brands. The housing blew me away. I was just telling my people, I was like, you know what, just leave me here in the student housing because it's free and you don't have to pay for my hotel. They're condos. They're condos that are being rented by local Antiguans, and they're very modern, as you can see. Some of them have two bedrooms and you share with a roommate. Some of them may have four bedrooms and you share with your roommates. You have the common area. You walk outside, you have a pool, you might have a hot tub, and then you walk over and you have a view of the ocean. I was just like, leave me here. Don't even bother to come back and get me. It was really, really nice. So what's our admissions philosophy? As I told some students that were here earlier, we are looking at students holistically. So I'm going to be looking at not just your cumulative GPA, but also your pre-med GPA. But not just those, I'm also going to look at any type of clinical experience you've had, any shadowing experience that you've had. I'm going to be looking at community service. What have you done in the community for your community? So we use a holistic approach. We're going to look at all of the components of your package, not just one aspect. Grades do matter. A lot of people are like, well, you know, do you really focus on grades? Yeah, we do. We're going to look at your grades. Basically, the grades matter because your grades are going to ensure your success. It's my job as an admissions advisor to make sure that I am setting you up for success. That's my job. I do not want to set anybody up for failure. That is not my job. I want you to be successful. And we're building a diverse student body, and that's critical to becoming a successful physician as well. So the application process is in timelines. It's rolling admissions. You can apply anytime. AUA and KMCIC start in February and August. AICASA, January, May, or September. You can apply online, submit the required documents, interview with the ADOA. The admissions committee will then review each applicant and render the decision. So basically what I do after I interview the student, it's my responsibility to compile your packet, make sure all your documents are there, and forward it to the admissions committee. The admissions committee meets as a group and they evaluate you as a group. They render the decisions. I have no authority to render decisions. I just complete the packet for you and send it in. Once a decision is rendered, you're notified by email and phone. So you'll get an email from AUA in New York, and they'll let you know the decision. I will also be calling you and letting you know the decision. And if I can't reach you by phone, you'll be getting a second email from me asking you to please call me as soon as possible, because I want to tell you about your decision. Following acceptance, then you're required to submit your seat deposit within 14 days. So some students were asking me about prereqs for the College of Medicine. You need to have at least 90 credit hours of college work. We strongly recommend you completing your degree at your institution and having a BS or a BA. The prerequisites are 1 year, which is 8 hours, of inorganic or general chemistry with labs, organic chemistry with labs, general biology or zoology with labs, 1 semester of physics with a lab, 1 semester of English, and 1 semester of either calculus or statistics. As I told this gentleman earlier, we prefer to see statistics because of the pharmacology piece that you guys will be having to take once you're in medical school. It will allow you to better understand all of the statistics and everything that'll be coming at you in pharmacology. But if you have calculus, that's fine as well. We'll accept that as well. We also recommend upper level science subjects such as biochemistry, genetics, A&P, and microbiology. So what type of documents do you need? You're gonna need official transcripts from all colleges and universities that you've attended. So if Clemson is not the only university that you've ever attended, you've been to a community college or you've been to another school before you came to Clemson, we need official sealed transcripts from all of those institutions. We need 2 official letters of recommendation, at least 1 from a science professor. So any of you that have had class with Dr. Smith, you would be going to him and saying, would you be so kind as to write me a letter of recommendation for school? You need a personal statement. Why do you want to be a physician? Why AUA? Why should we choose you? What is it about being a physician that drives you, that just, there's no other option for you? You have to be a physician. What is it? And we want you to articulate that via paper. We also want a resume or a curriculum vitae. I'm sure most of you probably already have that together, but basically that's just going to outline your educational experience, any work experience that you have, and then you're going to highlight your all of your clinical experiences, all of your shadowing experiences. You'll highlight any community service that you've done. If you've published any papers, we want to know about that. Any research that you've done, we want to know about that. So all of that would be on your resume. And we want the MCAT score report. Prior to 2013, we were not requiring the MCAT. Now we have changed the rules of admissions and we are looking for an MCAT score. Now, does that mean you won't be able to go to AUA if you didn't get a good score? No, it doesn't, because we're still evaluating students holistically. So if in fact you did not get the perfect MCAT score, maybe you got a 25, we're not gonna say, nope, can't come, not high enough. We just want you to take the exam. And this basically outlines our policy on MCAT scores. They're required from accepted students starting February 2013. They will not be used as a condition for acceptance. We don't believe that there is a correlation between the MCAT and your ability to be a competent, successful, empathetic physician. We're just going to have the score on record, and if it's a great score, you know, we'll use it to your benefit. A lot of people asked me earlier about the cost of tuition, and that's a great question. This is the breakdown of tuition. The investment for your education is less expensive than the median U.S. medical school. And as you can see, we're coming in at 161.7, so I rounded up to 162. A U.S. public is at 187.4. Ross is at 187.7. I'm sure you guys have heard of Ross. Anybody who's done some research on offshore schools, you know about Ross. St. George University, another offshore school, 226, 168, and then any U.S. private school is coming in at 264. So it's a significant difference, huge. So we also offer private student loans to cover the cost of attendance. We have student financial services that can assist you with exploring financial solutions. We have debt management counselors if you're struggling with some debt and you need to clear that up. We have people who can help you with that as well. VA benefits if you qualify, post 9/11 or the Montgomery GI Bill. And there are scholarship opportunities that are listed on our website. And they're listed here as well. Academic and professional recognition, the Admissions Committee Scholarship for Academic Achievement, the EMT or Paramedic Recognition Award, and then we have some diversification scholarships such as the Medical School Physician Diversification Initiative Grant, U.S. Military Veterans Recognition Award, an Antiguan Scholarship, and the AAPI AUA KMCIC Scholarship for Indian Students. So basically, to wrap it up, why would you want to consider AUA? And these are the reasons why. We have New York State approval, we're recognized by California, we have CAM accreditation, definitely affordable. You're getting a global medical education. We are technologically advanced. We are a modern campus. We have exceptional faculty. Dr. Smith can attest to that. I'm sure he spoke with them. Two-semester curriculum aligned with U.S. medical schools, clinical rotations in the U.S., Canada, or India. It's up to you. And hundreds of graduates practicing throughout the U.S. and Canada. So when could you start? For the College of Medicine, we have the spring and fall terms. For AI CASA, spring, summer, and fall. And for KMCIC, spring and fall. So can any of you picture yourselves in that picture right there? And can you actually see yourself being a physician? Because after all those 4 or 5 years of hard work, 4 years of hard work, that's exactly where you'll be standing. So who has questions? No questions. I must be a fabulous presenter because there were no questions last night either. or my presentation is really, really thorough. Yes.
I was wondering what GPA and MCAT requirements would be like a really good qualification. What would you like, or what would you see that would be like outstanding from a student or make them like really unique?
Well, we're looking for GPAs of 3.0 or higher. And as far as outstanding or really, really unique, because we're evaluating each student holistically, I'll look at you based on what you've achieved versus I'll look at this gentleman based on what he's achieved. And as far as outstanding, me personally, everything creates a whole which makes you stand out. So your community service, your GPA, your pre-med GPA. I'm gonna look at all of that. The MCAT score. The MCAT score is just to know that you took it. The score really is not going to affect the decision one way or the other. But I'm gonna look at every little piece of what you've done, your shadowing experiences. You know, I'm gonna read your statement and see what it is about being a physician. What's really driving you? What is this passion for medicine? All of that, to me, each student stands out individually on their own based on what they write and what it is about medicine that motivates them and really is their passion. Other questions?